dispatched just shortly before 4 o'clock for a subject in the water that hadn't resurfaced. And upon our arrival, we found 5 civilians in the water attempting to find the subject. Our first priority was to get all of them out of the water so we could start our operation. Just immediately, the resources that we're going to need on scene from, you know, the past history with the falls. We've done a number of rescues here, so we as chiefs know the resources that we'll need, and then we call for them immediately. You know, our first priority is firefighter safety. We have to make sure that anyone that's working around the water has a life jacket on, has pump caps on, for their personal safety before we even start the rescue. So, you know, every time the alarm goes off, there is an amount of worry. No one definitely knows the undercurrents here, with the rock formations, which way the undercurrents go. You know, we understand that civilians have the fight or flight in their body. They're either going to, you know, run away from it or go try to help. But the problem is they're potential victims also. I heard that one had not resurfaced and there was 5 additional in the water. My first priority was to get the ones that we could still see out of the water. As a chief, you need to calm everyone down first, get everyone's head collected, because we as firefighters, we want to go in. We have bystanders that are usually, you know, yelling at us, thinking that we're not doing anything, thinking that we're not moving fast enough. But, you know, as firefighters, we know that we have to slow down, collect our thoughts, and do everything safely. It was a multi-jurisdictional call. So, you know, you have response times, and, you know, you have to account for every agency's firefighters that are on scene and responding.
The current is pushing you downstream, so you're constantly having to work up against it. Really tough for the diver from Alden to work underwater against the current, but for us on the surface, we did all right because we were working in the shallow. Yeah, so we were using poles to search what we could at the bottom, feel around, see what we could feel, you know, as we scrape across rocks, seeing if we could, you know, make a quick grab in somebody in shallow water. So we just work around the edges with the poles the best we can to work deeper as we're a surface team, and so we can find. The safety concerns are the waterfalls, obviously the water's churning really, really bad there. And we had some undercut rocks where the water actually is cut under, and there's an area, a shelf basically underwater. So those are always high areas of concern when you're working in swift water.